There are a large number of babies that lose their life every year from preventable causes.
One of the leading causes is neonatal respiratory illness. This is basically when a premature baby can't get enough oxygen.
CPAP can improve survival by 66%. If that's the case, why isn't CPAP everywhere?
But they're not everywhere, especially in poor countries, because the problem is the price tag. A CPAP device can cost up to $15,000. That's expensive, but affordable in countries like the US. In developing countries, that cost is prohibitive and well out of reach for hospitals. So Dr. Burke and his team at Vayu created a CPAP machine that works just as well, doesn't need electricity, and only costs $100.
The team at Vayu is remarkable. We like to say we can solve anything with a couple of popsicle sticks.
Obviously, we're not in a traditional lab space. Where are we?
Right, this is a cross between Frankenstein's lab and the Batcave, I guess.
Working in a lab that looks straight out of a comic book, the team at Vayu is innovating their way to more accessible healthcare for everyone. This is me the day I was born. I was 12 weeks premature and needed emergency air in my lungs. I was on a ventilator, then a CPAP machine for the first couple days of my life. I was fortunate enough to be born in the US and have access to top care, including an expensive CPAP machine. My parents and their insurance were charged hundreds of dollars every day I needed oxygen. That cost of care and expensive equipment is largely unaffordable in developing countries. So Dr. Burke's work started with a simple question: does this device need to be so expensive? Enter Vayu Global Health. These scientists and engineers are dreaming up affordable, life-saving inventions.
Working on the protocol again.
It's a lot of training sessions that we're putting into play.
The foundation of their work is a concept called reverse innovation. It's creating solutions that are simpler and cheaper than the status quo, but just as effective.
Space is one of the more unusual laboratories you could ever see. A wonderful friend thought what we do is really great, so he's given us a portion of the second floor of his home.
After Dr. Burke and his team develop an ultra-low-cost, disruptive innovation, they bring it to developing countries around the world.
When a baby is born premature, their lungs may not be fully developed. Often, it overwhelms them and they don't survive.
In the developing world, 20 to 38% of deaths in the first 48 hours of life are attributed to respiratory failure.
CPAP should be in every single place that a baby is born. So we brought devices to Muhimbili National Hospital in Tanzania. It's a classic story throughout low resource settings all over the world. Each hospital has a graveyard of well-intentioned equipment. Other countries will send things, but if no one knows how to repair them, they quickly become unusable. So we make something that's simple to use for the provider.
Dr. Burke and his team work with the Muhimbili staff to deploy the simpler, easy-to-use Vayu CPAP. The invention works so well, the hospital team adopted it ahead of schedule.
When I think about being in Tanzania, I think about an 800-gram baby. That's a tiny little baby. The only reason that baby was alive was because of the expert care that was given by the staff, including the Vayu Bubble CPAP device. And that baby did well and ultimately was able to be discharged. There's nothing that can describe the joy that I felt.
The CPAP machine is just the tip of the iceberg. The Vayu laboratory is stacked high with all kinds of medical inventions aimed at providing people with more affordable care, like the Vayu uterine balloon.
In South Sudan, 1 in 6 women lose their life from pregnancy-related causes.
The number one cause of maternal death in developing countries is postpartum hemorrhage. Fortunately, there are a couple ways to treat the condition, including a uterine balloon, which inflates and lines the walls of the uterus to stop bleeding.
It's very successful. It's used throughout the world, but the devices are generally $400 a piece. Can we make it with local materials? What do they have locally? Ultimately came up with using a Foley catheter, which is very standard everywhere in the world, and then affixing to the end of that Foley catheter a condom.
It sounds dead simple, but it's backed up by a ton of scientific work.
28 clinical trials in the field. It's a fully approved device. In India, instead of $400, it costs $3.50. And it's now in most countries in the world.
Vayu's low-cost devices have saved a lot of lives abroad. But reverse innovation goes one step further. It's about creating a device that works just as well or better than the high-cost version. So much so that it can be adopted in developed countries.
Just because we are a developed society doesn't mean we have to continue to solve problems with an ever-escalating price tag.
But it's not that easy, especially in the US.
Reverse innovation, it goes significantly against the system. I mean, healthcare in our country is a business. It's not designed as a public good. You suddenly come in and say, I have a device that is 100 times less expensive. Roadblocks will be put in place. It would have to start with really changing what healthcare is, and it would have to be pushed into a public good framework.
VIU has been able to make some headway in the US. Both the uterine balloon and specifically the CPAP device are used in remote hospitals. For Dr. Burke and his team, the roadblocks are just inspiration to keep innovating.
Each of those lives that are saved, I imagine what that means for the family. If lives are being saved and lives are being improved, then we've been successful.
Thanks for watching. For more great stories about people and ideas that are changing the world, subscribe to Freethink now.